In this video, we'll take up the problem where a chain is falling. There is a free fall of chain on a surface, and the length of chain is L, and it is falling freely. We have to show that, we have to prove that at any given moment, if the chain, the length X, has fallen down, the force which is being exerted by the chain which is still in air and falling down would be twice the force which is exerted by this part. Now, this problem should be done in the following manner. First of all, there are certain assumptions which we need to keep in mind. One is that we are ignoring the interaction forces, the loss of energy due to interaction forces between the links of the chain. So we assume that there is no loss. That is number one. This is a free fall. There is no force which is stopping the movement, which is restricting the movement. And if we take this as, say, the length initially, and this as the length at given point of time, this is L minus X, and if the mass is M, total mass is M of the chain, then mass per unit length B, lambda B M upon L, is the mass per unit length. So the mass per unit length at the total mass of this part would be M upon L into L minus X is the mass of this chain. There is no force which is acting on the chain which could restrict the movement of the chain, which is the links which are coming down. Of course, the chain is exerting force when it is striking the ground, but this force is not halting or anyway impacting the movement of the links which are in the air and which are coming down, because as I said that we are assuming that there is no interactive forces between the links of the chain. Now, since it still remains a free fall, mass into acceleration, I'll say M dash, this is M dash, is equal to mg, m dash g. So the acceleration is g always for whatever is the part which is in the air. So if the acceleration is g, this link which is at the moment t about to strike or just striking the ground has traveled the distance x. This is x which has already come down at a given point of time. So this link has traveled the distance x if this link is the link which is striking the floor or the surface or the table, whatever may be given in the problem. So what is the velocity of this link at that point of time? V is equal to twice g into x. V square is equal to twice gx. V square is equal to u square plus twice as is the formula which we are using. And when the chain started falling, the velocity was zero. And at this point of time, the velocity is equal to root twice gx. Now, since it is striking the floor, there is a force which is exerted, which is because if we focus on this part only, the change in momentum we have to find out. What is the change in momentum? Momentum of this particular part of chain, let dm be the mass of this link, is dmv. This is the momentum, or I can say delta P of the link, because when it strikes, its momentum is zero, it becomes stationary, its velocity is zero. So this is the change in momentum which is happening. Dm is the small mass which is striking and it is coming to rest. Each of the link after striking the floor or the surface or the table is coming to rest. So this is the change in momentum. Now what is dp upon dt is equal to dm upon dt into v. What is dm upon dt? Dm upon dt would be, what is the delta m? If we take this as dx, this we take this link as dx, the delta m is, dm is lambda dx, and dm upon dt would be lambda dx upon dt is equal to lambda times v. Lambda times v is the dm upon dt. Now dp upon dt would be dp upon dt. This is, sorry, dp, because we are saying delta t tending to 0. So we have written delta p upon delta t as dp upon dt is equal to lambda times v into v, so which is lambda v square. This is the force which the link is exerting on the floor when it is striking. It is striking like this and coming to rest. This is the small, if we take this as the small part of the chain which is the link, it is coming, striking and stopping, and this is how, this is the momentum change, per rate of change of momentum, which is the nothing but the force. Now what is v square? Lambda v square would be lambda twice gx. So this is the force which is exerted. What is the force exerted by the part of the chain which is already on the ground? That is equal to lambda times x into g, where x is the length, lambda is the mass per unit length, g is the gravity, so this is the force. So this relationship shows it is twice lambda gx, it is lambda gx. It means the force which is exerted by this link when it is striking the floor is twice the weight of the chain which is already there. So this solves the problem. Thank you.